In this clip, we will introduce the concept of combination methods. In particular, we will derive the bone ratio method, and we will introduce some additional combination methods. The idea of combination methods is that they provide information about the surface fluxes of sensible and latent heat by combining the concept of the surface energy balance with what we have learned about turbulent transport. In the case of the Bowen ratio method, the starting point is the description of vertical fluxes in terms of the vertical differences of temperature and water vapor concentration. To link those fluxes to the vertical differences, we use the aerodynamic resistance. But rather than quantifying those resistances based on our knowledge about turbulent transport, we will try to eliminate them. To that end, we first take the ratio of the sensible heat flux and the latent heat flux. The dimensionless ratio that results we will call the Bowen ratio. Now we substitute the resistance expressions for the fluxes, the sensible heat flux to the left and the latent heat flux to the right. Next, we assume, as is commonly done, that the resistances for moisture and heat transport are the same. Then the Bowen ratio turns out to be simply the ratio of the vertical temperature difference over the vertical moisture difference, multiplied by a factor consisting of the specific heat over latent heat of vaporization. However, this Bowen ratio does not give us the flux yet. To that end, we need to combine the Bowen ratio with the surface energy balance. This gives us two equations, the energy balance equation and the expression for the Bowen ratio, with two unknowns, the sensible heat flux and the latent heat flux. By combining the equations, we obtain expressions for the sensible heat flux and the latent heat flux. In practice, some problems may occur. First, if the Bowen ratio is close to -1, the denominator approaches 0 and hence the resulting flux is undefined. A Bowen ratio close to -1 implies that the available energy, that is net radiation minus solid flux, is close to 0. A second potential problem is that the vertical differences in temperature or humidity become so small that they cannot be determined well. The observations at each level have a finite accuracy, say 1/10 of a degree, and this implies that the vertical difference has an accuracy of 2/10 of a degree. Well, if that is also the order of magnitude of the vertical difference itself, the error is 100%. Therefore, it is best to measure close to the surface where vertical differences are largest. On the other hand, one should measure above the roughness sublayer, since the assumptions underlying the method is that the aerodynamic resistances are defined and equal for temperature and moisture. Whereas the Bowen ratio requires observations at two levels in the atmosphere, there is also a class of combination methods that need observations at only one height. However, those methods come with additional complexities. First, the dependence of the fluxes on the aerodynamic resistance cannot be eliminated, and hence knowledge about the turbulent state of the atmosphere is needed. Furthermore, one needs to know the conditions for temperature and humidity at the surface. This problem is often circumvented by eliminating those conditions from the equations. Examples of those single-level combination methods are the Penman equation and the Penman-Matisse equation. To summarize, the combination methods, they combine the energy balance and expressions for the fluxes based on vertical concentration differences. To determine fluxes from the Bowen ratio method, you require observations of available energy and temperature and humidity at two heights. Alternatively, there are single-level combination methods. For that, on top of the available energy, you need temperature and humidity at one height, and there's information needed about turbulence.